Welcome to the SLAC National Accelerator Laboratory, a sprawling 426-acre site on the Stanford campus in Silicon Valley. 25 feet underground lies a 2-mile linear accelerator that passes beneath nearby Interstate 280. Electrons zip through the accelerator at nearly 670 million miles per hour, just a fraction slower than the speed of light.
So at SLAC we do all sorts of experiments, mostly to do with chemistry, physics, and a little bit of biology.
The lab is funded by the Energy Department and has been around since 1962. The work carried out at SLAC has produced 6 Nobel Prizes. Much of the research is at the fundamental level, pushing the very boundaries that will lead to innovation in electronics and information technology. And a lot of that work relies on this, the world's most powerful X-ray laser, called the LINAC Coherent Light Source, or LCLS. It's the first laser to produce hard X-rays that can be used to see down to the level of atoms and molecules.
There's no other place in the world where you can find short, coherent X-ray pulses like the ones here. And that enables them to really rip apart atoms, and sometimes literally, and actually look at how electrons are behaving in those atoms, in molecules.
Here's how it works. A laser generates a pulse of UV light that travels down and strikes the surface of a copper plate. This turns the light into a burst of electrons seen in blue, which enter the linear accelerator. Inside the accelerator, the electrons are converted into a compressed pulse, gaining energy as it travels. By the time it reaches the end of the accelerator, the electron pulse is traveling at nearly the speed of light. The electrons then enter the beam transport hall, where a pipe, focusing magnets, and diagnostic monitors move the delicate beam from the accelerator into the heart of the LCLS, the undulator hall, where the X-ray laser light is generated. Here, special magnets with alternating north and south poles cause the electrons to swerve back and forth, a process that forces them to give off X-rays. An electromagnet sends the electrons down to a special chamber where they're absorbed and their energy is dissipated. Meanwhile, the X-ray pulse, unaffected by the magnet, continues on and is ready for scientists to use in an experiment. Getting a chance to do an experiment here at SLAC is highly competitive. Proposals are reviewed by an international committee made up of 50 scientists, and only 1 in 5 are selected twice a year. So the competition and pressure is high. Among those who got through is Stanford professor Aaron Lindenberg, who is researching future data storage systems.
And once you get the time, you end up spending a year or something, you know, just getting ready for 5 days of experimental time.
Lindenberg just completed an experiment using the high-powered X-ray to observe the way atoms moved inside a material. As computer chips get faster and memory chips hold more and more data, scientists are getting closer to the very boundaries of physics. That makes it more important to peer deep inside materials and see how they work on an atomic level.
Questions we were trying to answer were, you know, what are the speed limits for these processes? How fast can these materials really move? How fast can you essentially write information? Are there ways of using light to kind of all optically manipulate materials in new ways?
For Lindenberg and other researchers like him, SLAC offers a unique testbed for their work, even if that means spending a week beneath the surface in a lab.
After I emerged from underground here, you know, I sort of had a it was sort of an interesting thing to look back and think, wow, we started this, you know, 4 or 5 years ago trying to answer these questions, and actually maybe now we have answers to some of them. It's probably too early to say exactly the final story on it, but yes, the experiment was a success.
Melissa Aparicio for the IDG News Service.